Hello everyone, I'm Isan. In this video, we'll share the latest features for various Samsung smartphones called Quick Launcher. This feature is incredibly useful because it can be used as a convenient shortcut for your everyday use. This new feature has just arrived in the latest update of One Hand Operation Plus application. For those of you who are already using the One Hand Operation Plus, you can simply update it to the latest version. Once you have updated the One Hand Operation Plus application, you can immediately open the application and activate the latest Quick Launcher feature. And for the options, as usual in the One Hand Operation Plus application, you can activate it in the short swipe section or in the long swipe section. In this video, we will demonstrate how to activate the Quick Launcher feature using the long swipe for both the left handle and right handle. To enable the Quick Launcher, simply select it from the options at the bottom. Additionally, you can customize the Quick Launcher display by clicking the settings button on the right. From there, you'll have the freedom to choose from three different views for the Quick Launcher display. Next, after selecting the desired column layout, you can customize the Quick Launcher by adding different pages to Quick Launcher. To add a new page to the Quick Launcher, simply open the Quick Launcher, then click the settings button located at the bottom right corner. And then press the plus sign to create a new page. Here you can have up to a maximum of 5 pages in the Quick Launcher section. If you want to delete a page that you have already added, you can open the page that you want to remove, then click the minus sign, and then click the delete button to remove the page from the Quick Launcher. Then here, to customize the appearance of application shortcuts or functions and settings, you can immediately open the Quick Launcher section, then click the settings button on the right. From there, click the app drawer button at the bottom, then here you just have to select the application that you want to add to the Quick Launcher. Here the maximum shortcuts that you can add to the Quick Launcher page is 24. And this limit only applies if you have selected the 4 column setting. If you choose the 3 column or 2 column setting, the number of application icons at the bottom will adjust accordingly. Then after adding the application icon you want to the Quick Launcher section, you can also easily adjust their positions. You can do it by simply open the Quick Launcher and press the settings button on the right. Then press and hold on one of the icons and slide it to the desired location. Then to add settings or functions to the Quick Launcher section, the process is the same as before. You can press the app drawer shortcut at the bottom right of the Quick Launcher. Then on the top tab, select the functions tab, which contains various settings that you can activate through this shortcut. Next, add the functions that you want to display in the Quick Launcher section, and then they will appear on the Quick Launcher page instantly. What makes the Quick Launcher feature even more interesting is that on each page, you have the options to add folders containing application icons and functions. Once you have added a folder, simply enter the Quick Launcher view and tap on the folder. From there, you can add application icons just like before. Similarly, you can also add functions directly into a folder by using the same method as before. To do this, you can just add a folder, then click on the app drawer icon on the right. This allows you to instantly add the functions you desire into that folder. This launcher looks very interesting and can be very useful in everyday use, especially if we compare this feature with edge panel feature that already existed on Samsung smartphones. The Quick Launcher feature looks a little bit better because it offers several advantages. Firstly, it can be accessed directly in landscape mode. Secondly, the ability to add folders contributes to a neater and more organized appearance. Apart from that, the shortcuts that you can add are not only application shortcuts, but you can also add shortcuts to specific settings and functions. Then here you can also deactivate this Quick Launcher feature in certain applications only. You can utilize the app exception settings in the One Hand Operation Plus. Here simply select the application for which you don't want to enable the One Hand Operation Plus feature. So later when you open those applications, the One Hand Operation Plus feature will be disabled. Additionally, there is also an option that you need to know in the One Hand Operation Plus application, which is the hide handle option. You can find the options directly in the One Hand Operation Plus settings in the advanced settings. Here you can easily disable the One Hand Operation Plus feature for specific scenarios, including landscape mode, quick panel, lock screen, and home screen. For those of you who are still not too familiar with the One Hand Operation Plus and would like to explore more of its features, we have covered detailed explanations of these features and settings in several previous videos. You can easily check the video by clicking on the video that is currently displayed on the screen. Hopefully useful. See you in the next video.